On the Nintendo console, you can hardly ever go wrong with Mario title, and Mario Kart DS is no exception. The game is really fun, with crisp graphics, colorful environments, and familiar sound effects that we all have come to love since the original Mario Kart. What makes this Mario Kart shine are its courses. They're very unique and challenging. Wario's pinball level and the battleship level are my favorites. From all the Mario Kart games I've played, like Super Mario Kart, Mario Kart 64, this game, in my opinion, has the best race courses. Furthermore, this game includes 4 retro Grand Prix Cups, meaning 16 courses have been selected and have been included from the previous Mario Kart games. And it's just really cool to replay the classic courses again. I was pretty surprised to find that I could play the Donut Course and Choco Mountain on this game. Some of my favorite courses didn't make it in the list, but it was still cool to play the classic courses. Battle mode is in this game too, and with bots, it's lots of fun. It can be tough, but taking out Mario characters, balloons, or stars have never been so fun. And of course, this game is online capable, which is, in my experience with the DS, is rare in DS games. It's not quite as fun as split screen with buddies, but it's still very awesome. But of course, it's not without flaws. Each Mario character is given the option to drive a standard kart or their custom kart. And to be honest, the difference between two options are hard to notice, except for the fact that the kart will rarely get you, that one kart will rarely get you any good items during the race, and the other might be a bit slower. Such difference makes the game a bit stale, because items are what makes Mario Kart games fun, and the fact that you have to sacrifice it for a little increase in speed, that doesn't go well in my book. The difficulty levels in the Grand Prix mode are executed rather strangely, and in the 50cc, as you'd expect, it's ridiculously easy to win the first race. But from 100cc onwards, you'll find yourself completely frustrated because no matter which character you choose, two or three characters are always faster than you, and it's random. You know, I had some matches where I was playing as Yoshi or Toad, and Bowser, just normal speed, was going faster than me without any items or whatever. Just Bowser, Wario, Donkey Kong, sometimes Peach, Mario. It's just totally random. Once the game randomly selects like two characters who drive the fastest, and then two characters who drive the slowest, you'll always see. So if you're in a tournament, you'll always see the two characters who are 7th or 8th place. You'll always see the characters who are 2nd or 3rd place, because I'm always 1st place, of course. But yeah, that was just weird. And on 150cc, the hardest difficulty setting, it's just ridiculous. The rubber banding AI of this game is ridiculous. You have to use items to knock them out constantly, or you'll lose, really, because the speed is so determined at random. That's really my biggest beep with racing with the computer opponents. It's just this difficulty is just so set. It's so unfair, you know. I guess that's just to be expected because Mario Kart really doesn't require a racing strategy other than to just kind of slide, you know, do a little jump and do back and forth to kind of do the snaking. I think that's what it's called, snaking. We got the Z's and you got a speed boost. Whatever, that's really the only strategy with Mario Kart games. Other than that, you just get random items, and you just throw them out, and you just kind of just go through the course. You know, Mario Kart games have never really been about strategy or skills, it's just been about having a bunch of fun. And that it does, except when the computer AI is so rubber-banded, and so artificial, and so arbitrary. Another thing is that there's this thing called Mission Mode, and it sucks. Mission Mode sucks. I've beaten about 35 missions, and I had to stop because I just couldn't handle the monotonous bore any longer. All missions pretty much work like this. Collect all coins, drive through all gates in order, smash through all the boxes in the course, or do this many turbo boosts in this many laps. There may be a little variations in that, but that's pretty much what the missions are like. Oh, and after you beat the 9 missions, you get to play a boss level. But don't get too excited, that's really boring too. Another thing is that the music seems to be very, very lackluster in this Mario Kart game. Maybe I'm expecting too much out of my DS Lite, but I was very disappointed. The music's not dynamic, it's not really interesting, and it's not even that kiddish, enjoyable type of music. It's just kind of bland. And as much as I love the new graphics of Mario Kart DS, the animations in Mario Kart, you know, DS is still not as good as I expect. But it is a pretty... really fun DS game. It's one of the best-selling DS games. It's what sold like 20 million or something, and it's for good reason. You could never really go wrong with Mario Kart unless Mario Kart Wii, but that's another topic. So, really good game. Just really fun. Just the flaws with the AI and the difficulty is really what threw me over the boat and the mission mode. But, you know, that's not what you play Mario Kart for. You play for the fun, crazy courses and just casual fun with great items and great racing, and it still has all that in a handheld format.